Royal watchers who are hoping to get the first glimpse of baby Sussex, as Meghan emerges from hospital may well be disappointed, royal commentators have claimed. Speaking in the podcast on air, British correspondent Emily Andrews and American commentator Omid Scobie reported that Harry and Meghan are not planning an on-the-steps moment with their newborn. The Duchess of Cambridge delivered all three of her children at the Lindo Wing, and appeared on the steps looking picture-perfect each time, just like her late mother-in-law Diana, but apparently Meghan will not follow suit. At the moment, we understand that she doesn't want to do that, isn't going to do that, Emily said. Omid added that it would go against Meghan's feminist beliefs, saying, given what we know about Meghan, the optics of a totally glamorous, picture-perfect moment hours after giving birth are not quite in alignment with her views on the world. There might also be simple, more practical reason being the lack of post-birth media appearance. Meghan might very well forego the Lindo Wing at St. Mary's Hospital altogether. Emily said she has been told the birth will not happen at the Lindo Wing, but said Kensington Palace refused to confirm this. For each of Kate's births, the council put parking restrictions in place around the Lindo Wing of the hospital. This time around, however, the council aren't aware of any parking restriction for the street facing the Lindo Wing in April. Omid suggested that the couple might have selected a private hospital closer to their new abode, Frogmore Cottage in Windsor. Recently, sources claimed that the Duchess of Sussex will opt for a maternity unit near to her and Prince Harry's home in Windsor, Frogmore Cottage, to avoid the stress of a massive global interest in her pregnancy. And Meghan's decision to rebuff St. Mary's Hospital's famous wing is also reportedly so the mother-to-be is not seen to be copying Kate. Harry and Meghan realize there is intense public interest, but this baby is not a direct heir to the throne and they want the birth to be as private as possible, the source told The Sun. Meghan is nervous about complications such as an emergency cesarean and doesn't want the pressure of having to look immaculate on the hospital steps just hours later. The source said that the Duchess of Sussex did not want to be primped and blow-dried to within an inch of her life immediately after giving birth but wanted to spend the precious time with her newborn. There's plenty of rumors swirling about Duchess Meghan and Prince Harry's first child, as she's expected to give birth soon. Among the rumors is one that's been rampant for a while, which is that the couple is actually expecting twins, not just one baby. Of course, there's no real proof at this point of twins, but for some reason, lots of people are betting that this is the case. And thanks to what could have been a cryptic comment by Prince Harry recently, the rumors are heating up. The comment was allegedly made by Harry to Simon Weston, who is a Falklands War veteran, according to The Express. Weston recalled a conversation that the two had last week during a reception at the Buckingham Palace. "We joked about Wales defeating England in the Six Nations rugby. I also warned him and the Duchess it serves him right as they will be getting plenty of sleepless nights when the baby is born." And what followed was the comment that could have been a hint of twins. Weston noted, "Harry said if they have any more than two it will serve him right." Of course, there's no telling what Harry meant by that. It could have just been a strange joke, or perhaps he accidentally let it slip that they're expecting twins. For now, there's not much fans can do except to simply wait and wonder. Undoubtedly, speculation of the baby's name and gender are going to ramp up until the official announcement is made. In other news, Markle made a splash with her glitzy baby shower in NYC last week. But it's emerged now that she headed to Doria Ragland's house in Los Angeles before jetting back to the UK, reported Elle. The visit isn't altogether surprising, considering that Meghan is believed to have a close relationship with her mom. And when you consider that the rest of the Markle clan has been embarrassing the Duchess publicly, one can only imagine the mom-daughter duo is closer now than ever before. An insider emphasized this point. "Meghan is a mummy's girl. Their special mother-daughter bond hasn't disappeared just because she's moved to England. Meghan will always come back to Doria, this will always be her home. They are forever in touch, and Meghan has been here to stay on more than one occasion since going public with Harry. I even saw him here once, but it's not my place to say any more."